I look into the world and I see a lot of leaders who are self-serving. I see countries who put protectionism before collaboration with others. And so it all seems very contradictory. How do we make sense of this? The first thing I wanted to comment on is the self-serving leader. If we really explore what's underlying that, it's ambition. The ambition to achieve something substantial, the ambition to make a name for oneself, the ambition to make money, the ambition to be famous, whatever it is. And you know what? Ambition itself isn't bad. It's inherent in most of us. And achieving that ambition can be quite fun as well. Now, what we have to do as leaders in the 21st century is making sense of that ambition. Making sure that we understand the people who we lead, what their personal ambition is. For quite a while, I was leading an employee of mine over a number of years, and his ambition wasn't any of the things that I just mentioned before. It was to have a thriving and happy family life. So once I understood that ambition of that individual, it became far easier to manage the relationship because it was all about helping him making time for his family, helping him to develop in a way that he could achieve the things that he wanted to achieve at work in less time so he could actually spend more time with his family. So if you go and understand the ambition of your employees, but also if you go and understand your own ambition, what is it that you truly want to achieve, then you are becoming a better leader in the 21st century. The second thing I mentioned is protectionism. It appears that in many countries we try to close up our borders, whether it's Brexit, whether it is in the US where there's a trade war between China and the US and to some lower extent between Russia and some other countries. And sometimes we forget that the world we have created is based on collaboration. Protectionism in itself is just a mindset of scarcity. We think that if we provide something, that nobody else can provide it. It's a little bit like this YouTube channel. I talk about leadership, I talk about business, I talk about life, and there are many other creators that also talk about the same topics. But I don't see them as competition. In a lot of cases, they are an inspiration because I see topics that they create and that users and viewers want to watch. I also look at them for inspiration of what could make my videos better. The most successful companies in the world today are those who have a culture of collaboration. So if you want to be a leader in the 21st century, you need to understand that collaboration beats competition in these days. So what about those social enterprises, the purpose-driven life, the servant leader? Are those contradictory to ambition and collaboration? And I don't think they are. The former two, they are components of our nature as human beings. We want to bring our best into an enterprise, but that doesn't mean that we don't care about what the enterprise does. And so understanding the complexities of the social landscape around us, whether it's environmental issues, cultural issues, socio-economical issues, or equality questions, those are things that become more and more relevant in today's business. And so as a leader in the 21st century, you have to look around yourself. You have to ask whether the purpose that you have in the organization, the vision that you formulated for your enterprise, adds up to the social understanding of the people who work there, but also your clientele. It just occurs to me, there is one more thing that is incredibly important these days. It hasn't existed 100 years ago, and that is hitting the like button, because for the low price of $0, you can support this channel. You can help us spread the message further. But in all seriousness, the real challenge of the 21st century isn't technology, isn't the fast pace of events. It is rather understanding ourselves and understanding those who we lead, what their ambitions are, how we can better support them to collaborate more, and also have an understanding of what their social norms are and how we can integrate them into the vision of our company. I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Hit that subscribe button when you want to be part of this community. until later.